heard of sea and sky. I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I will raise the stars of night. I will make the darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall
I'd like to welcome all of you to this funeral mass today for Francey O'Hara. Those who have traveled a distance, those of different Christian tradition than ours, those who maybe find it difficult to believe in God. All of you are welcome to our mass. In our mass today, we pray for the happy repose of the soul of Francey, confident that God will forgive him any sin he may have committed. We pray for his wife and family in their time of grief and loss, that God, the Holy Spirit, will comfort them, reassure them. We pray in our own journey of life, we will make good choices that reflect love and truth and goodness. With these thoughts, let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command that the name of your servant Francey to be inscribed in the book of life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. We now listen to the Word of God. I invite Brendan and Phelim to come forward to read for us.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for us to be busiest about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into our hearts without or ever discovering, from beginning to end, the work which God has done.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, that on the word of the Lord, those who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Please stand to greet the gospel.
Be with you. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I've gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you're going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. I'd like to begin by offering my sympathy to all of you who grieve and mourn for Francey, to his many good friends in the town of Antrim and elsewhere, to his neighbours, especially those from Fairfields, where he lived for the vast majority of his life, to the family circle, to his sister Jean, to his 7 grandchildren, whom he was very proud of, and whom he was caring and loving towards, and to his own children, to Kieran, Declan, Brendan, and Joanne. They today thank God for the gift of their father and the love he shared with them. They will treasure the memories they have of him, and they will influence them in their lives. Their father was a good influence in all of them. I know they appreciate what he gave to them, what he did for them. They're proud of him. And so to the 4 of them today, I offer sympathy. What I know is a tremendous loss. But the one whom will miss him most is his wife, Mavis. They met when they were 18 years of age, married when they were 22, been together for 58 years. life-giving love and partnership. It was a good example of the grace of the sacrament of marriage. Because it was life-giving, because it influenced not just their own family, neighbors, but the community, people around them. They loved one another, and in turn, that love inspired them to do good things, to be kind and good neighbors, to be good people. And so the loss for Mavis is immense. And we ask God to give her the grace and strength she will need in the days ahead. Any time I met Francey, there were two memories I have. First, he was usually smiling and in good humour. And second, I got the impression that he was a contented man who enjoyed his life and dealt with whatever came his way. These last few days, listening to Mavis and his family, that talk about him gave me the clear understanding my impression was true. Francey was a contented man. Born and bred in Antrim, he had a love for the area, especially the loch. He enjoyed spending time tinkering with the boat, the Mary P. He also loved traditional music and played the boran and did set dancing, but could dance almost any dance. In his younger days, he competed in the Circuit of Ireland rally his good friend Bobby Elliott. Indeed, he had worked for Bobby for many years in the garage business. Francey had trained as a mechanic and worked hard all his life to support his wife and provide for his family. Francey had a good relationship with God. He made space for God in his life, trusted in God's love and care for him. He did the best with what God gave to him, and that began with the gift of baptism when Christ promised him his share in his resurrection and a share in the gift of eternal life. Every time Francey prayed, received Holy Communion or the sacraments, or did a good turn, he grew closer to God and deepened his contentment. Francey lived his faith. It influenced his decisions and judgment, the choices he made in life. He was committed to Christ and lived as a baptized person to the best of his ability. Today we commend him to God, confident that God will welcome him into his peace. On Thursday evening, with his loving wife and family in support, Francey died contentedly and completed his journey to God. May he rest in peace. Now we invite those who are reading the prayers of the faithful to come forward. Garen, Maeve, and Patrick, and the rest was to stand. God Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Let us pray for Granda. We thank God for the gift and privilege of knowing Granda and thank him for the love, joy, and laughter he brought into our lives. May he continue to inspire us and watch over us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for Granda's family, especially Granny. May God fill their hearts with his comfort at this difficult time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who mourn. May their tears be wiped away and may their mourning be turned into joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for Granda, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be at peace with the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for all those who are grieving the loss of Granda. His family and friends, may they all be consoled and strengthened at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. For a moment we pray for our own intention today. However great or small it may be, we ask God's help in the quiet of our heart. Lord, hear us. God, our loving Father, we make these prayers in faith through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. We now ask those who are carrying up the offertory gifts, Roshan and Liana, to carry the gifts from the back of the church. Let us stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Francey, may be taken on to glory with your Son, whose great mystery of love we are all united. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of eternal resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, the eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dew fall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, profess your resurrection till you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Noel our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Francey, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, St. Alphonsus, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may always praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. For the distribution of Holy Communion today, if you're coming forward to receive communion, I'd ask you to come up by the centre aisle and go back by the side aisles, and for the two side chapels to wait to the end before coming across and coming up the centre aisle. And because of COVID, I'd remind you that communion can only be received in the hand. And if you can't receive communion but you'd like to come forward in procession at this time, you can receive a blessing if you cross your arms like this, as you approach the minister of the Eucharist or myself, you can receive the blessing at communion time. If you're more comfortable remaining sitting where you are, please do so.
Yes.
And now a member of the family, Kathy, I think, is going to read the prayer after communion.
May the Lord support us all the day long, till the shades lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over, and our work is done.
Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Francey may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Prayers of commendation. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Francey. Now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Francey again and enjoy his friendship. Though this family and congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. In that faith, we sprinkle his remains with holy water, reminder of his baptism and the promise of eternal life. We incense his remains to remind us of the sacredness of the body, a temple of the Holy Spirit. As we do these two things, let us pray in silence for the happy repose of the soul of Francey. Response to the psalm, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Francey, the sure and certain hope, together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Francey in this life, their signs to us of your goodness, for fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. To all meet in Christ, we are with you and our brother forever and ever. Amen. My friends, in peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Yeah.